You can see my screen, right?
I can see your screen, Dinesh. Yes, thank you.
Okay, perfect. Very good. So, are you ready? Can we start the training?
Yes, Inventor? Yes, sir, we can start the training. Yes.
Okay, perfect. So, welcome to Autodesk Inventor training. To start with, let me introduce. I am Dinesh Tiwari. I am from Mumbai, India, and currently associated as a corporate trainer in Koenig with an experience of more than 10 years. To say about my achievements, I am LPI certified TPM trainer. Also, I am Flutter certified application developer. Also, I am Microsoft certified Power Automate RPA developer associate and Boomi certified associate integration developer. And my domain here includes working with automation tools like Power Automate, UiPath, programming knowledge of C, C#, Python, C++, and structural design softwares like AutoCAD, Inventor, Tekla Structure, Revit, Navisworks. So this is me, your trainer, Dinesh Tiwari here, to train you on Autodesk Inventor, a software that is focused on 2D and 3D mechanical designs, simulation, and documentation. So it is widely used in various industries, including manufacturing, engineering, and product design. Okay, so that's all about me and my experience. Now, I would also like to hear from you about your experience, your working domain, and then your objective and your expectations with this training. So, okay. So here you can see in all, we have total 15 modules, okay, that we are going to cover in our upcoming sessions, starting with chapter number one, Introduction to Autodesk Inventor, which will introduce Autodesk Inventor user interface to you, different Inventor environments, okay, and method for identifying Inventor files. Okay. It will also explain you how to create a project, invoke a marking menu, how you can customize the color scheme, how you can choose the user interface theme, how you can export files to other CAD formats, how you can save files, how you can open existing files. All those things, introduction level, will come in module number one.
Okay.
Once we have done with module number two, the second module, Drawing Sketches with Autodesk Inventor, in which we will start with, we will discuss how to invoke part modeling and sketching environment. Okay, so it will explain, it will explain you how to specify the units as well as grids and snap settings here. Okay. Besides, this chapter will also introduce method for drawing lines, rectangles, circles, ellipses, arcs, slots, polygons, and spin lines by using the respective sketching tools. Okay. It also discusses how to edit a spin line as well. Okay. So with the understanding to that, next we will move to chapter number three, editing and modifying sketches, which will introduce various editing and modifying operations such as trimming unwanted sketch entities, extending sketch entities, how you can split, offsetting. Okay, it also explains how to create 2D fillets, chamfers, construction and center line entities, okay, pattern sketch entities, how you can mirror your sketch entities, okay, in addition to the methods for like copying, rotating, scaling, and stretching your sketch entities. Okay, so all those editing and modifying sketches will be covered in chapter number three.
Okay.
Next, coming to chapter number four, where we will introduce various constraints and different methods also for applying them. So this chapter will discuss how to control the display of constraints in the drawing area, how you can apply different dimensions, how you can control your dimension settings and edit dimensions. It also introduces working with different states of a sketch and displaying available degrees of freedom of a sketch entities. Okay, that is what we are going to see in chapter number four.
Okay.
Okay. Next, in chapter number 5, creating base feature of solid model, where we will start with the 3D modeling. Okay. So it explains the three default planes, front, top, and right. Okay. Which may not be enough for creating models having multiple features. Okay. Therefore, this chapter will discuss how to create additional work planes. Okay. Additionally, it also elaborates on how you can create different work axes, work points, and user coordinate systems.
Okay.
Next, in module number six, okay, creating work features. Okay. We will be discussing all about those that I mentioned just now. Okay. In this, we will also discuss about how you can create extrude and revolve base features. Okay. By using extrude and revolve tools. Okay. So this chapter will also describe how you can navigate a model by using mouse buttons, by view cube, navigation tools such as navigation wheel, panning, zooming, and orbiting. Okay. Further, it will also explain how you can change the visual style of a model to realistic, to shaded, shaded with edges, and shaded with hidden edges. All those will come in. So once we have understanding of all these first six modules, then from chapter number 7, we will start with modeling part, advanced modeling, which will introduce the advanced option for creating your extrude and revolve features. Okay. It will discuss how to work with a sketch which is having multiple profiles. Okay. It will explain how to project the geometries of existing feature onto the sketching plane, like intersecting edges of a model onto sketching plane, 2D sketch onto a face of a model, and geometries of a DWG file onto the sketching plane. Okay. So this chapter will also elaborate on creating a section view and editing a feature and its sketch as well. Okay. So all those things, after finishing that, we will also see how you can assign an appearance, how you can apply a material to your model, and how you can calculate the physical properties of your model as well in this module.
Okay.
In chapter number 8, advanced modeling 2, where we will discuss how to create sweep features, loft features, coil feature, emboss feature, mark features, rib feature. Okay. It will also discuss the methods for applying an image on a face of a model and how you can create a shell feature as well.
Okay.
In module number 9, pattern and mirroring, okay, it will introduce methods for creating rectangular patterns, circular patterns, and sketch-driven patterns. It will also discuss about suppressing and unsuppressing features and pattern occurrences, okay, as well as mirroring a feature or a body about a mirroring plane.
Okay.
Then in module number 10, we will talk about how to create simple clearance tabbed and taper tabbed holes, okay, as per the standard specification by using the hole tool. Okay. It also explains you how to create threads, different types of fillets and chamfers, how you can split a face and a solid body, as well as how to create 3D sketches and curves as well.
Okay.
Then in module number 11, we will work with assemblies, okay, where we will discuss how to create assemblies by using bottom-up assembly approach. There are basically two approach, bottom-up and top-down assembly approach. So chapter number 11, we'll discuss on bottom-up assembly approach, and chapter number 12, we'll discuss assemblies by using top-down assembly approach.
Okay.
Understood. So this chapter will introduce the procedures for inserting components into the assembly environment. Okay. It will also explain how you can work with degrees of freedom and apply various constraints. Okay. The application of various joints such as rigid, rotational, slider, cylindrical, and ball have been described in this chapter.
Okay.
Okay. Then chapter number 13, creating animations and exploded views, will discuss how to create animations of an assembly in the presentation environment. Okay, so this chapter will explain how to capture actions and tweaks on the timeline and discuss the methods for editing time and properties of a tweak, how you can delete a tweak, how you can create a snapshot view, how you can edit a snapshot view, how you can rename those snapshot view, how you can create a new storyboard. All those new scenes will be discussed, how you can play your animations, all those things will be discussed in chapter number 13.
Okay, very good.
In chapter number 14, working with drawings, here we will discuss how to create 2D drawings of a component and assemblies in the drawing environment with a focus on editing sheet size, title block, and drafting standards. Okay, so this chapter will introduce the concept and definition of angle of projections. Okay, how you can create various type of drawing views such as base view, projected view, section view, how you can delete a drawing view, how you can apply dimensions, how you can add text, notes, okay, how you can add surface finish symbols, all those things, bill of materials, everything will be discussed in detail here in this chapter number 40.
Okay. Wonderful.
Then in the last module, sheet metal design and simulation, where participants will learn and modify the sheet metal defaults. They will create various features such as faces, flanges, punches, develop corner seams, bend features, corner rounds, generate flat patterns, and they will also conduct stress analysis by defining materials, constraints, and input forces.
Okay.
So wonderful. In all this, all 15 modules will make you get pro in this Autodesk Inventor. Okay, any question, wonderful. Any queries you have in any of this module that we are going to cover in upcoming days?
No questions at all, Dinesh, no.
Okay,
perfect. It all looks very, very good, very exciting. Thank you.
Okay, welcome. So be prepared to invest your time in making drawings. Okay, and also I will say that be patient. Okay, as Inventor is a, I will not say it is a complex software, but yes, it is a software with a steep learning curve. So be prepared to invest your time and have some patience while making the drawing. Okay,
I will.
Yes, perfect. So the prerequisites for learning this software, there should be Inventor installed in your system. Is it installed in your system?
It is, Dinesh. I did it yesterday. Yes.
Okay. Perfect. Very good. And other things like computer skills are important. Understanding drafting and design concepts, while not mandatory, but having some basic understanding of drafting and design principles can be beneficial. Then technical drawing knowledge, you should be, Inventor is primarily used for technical drawings. So having some knowledge of technical drawing conventions such as dimensions, symbols, line types will be useful. Familiarity with 2D and 3D concepts will be very much helpful. And as I mentioned, patience and practice. Okay, it requires patience and consistent practice to become proficient. Okay, so be prepared to invest time in learning and exploring the softwares.
Yes, I shall.
Yes, and the training resources. Okay, I will provide you with various learning resources, including documentation, tutorials, and online thing. So take advantage of these resources to enhance your learning experiences.
I shall do. Okay. Thank you. I shall.
Okay. Okay, perfect. Very good. So there are total 15 modules, 15 plus hands-on exercises as well as practice exercises I will be sharing with you. Mm-hmm. So be ready for that. And we have 8 hours of session. So in this 8 hours of session, we will have 3 breaks in between. Okay, mm-hmm. We'll have a first break of 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. Then one big break for lunch for 60 minutes of lunch break.
Okay.
And one more, 15 minutes of just refreshment break.
Okay. Okay. That sounds good.
Okay. Perfect. What is the time at your place now?
Right now, Dinesh, it is 09:17. So it is literally 9:15 a.m.
Okay.
So 09:17.
Okay. Perfect.
So as what time is it with you, sir? I think you are about 8-9 hours ahead of me.
Yes. At my place, it is 1:47 p.m. now.
1:47. Okay.
Yes. So we will take the break as per your timing. Okay. Per your timing, we will take the breaks. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So get ready to dive into Inventor with our complete course package, including the course book, hands-on lab exercise material, virtual machine for practical applications, as well as qubit module-wise test. Okay, we will have module-wise test also to gauge your understanding and progress at every step. At every step. Okay, so you can see my screen, right?
Yes, I can.
Okay, perfect. Okay. So let's start with the very first module, Autodesk, introduction to Autodesk Inventor. It will be somewhat theoretical module to make you get acquainted with the interface first. Okay, so please bear with me. Okay. And just follow the steps that I am doing here on my screen. You can do the same thing on your screen as well.
Okay.
So welcome to the world of computer-aided design with Autodesk Inventor. So this is a product of Autodesk, one of the biggest technology providers for engineering, architecture, construction, manufacturing, media, and entertainment industries, offering robust software tools for 3D design that let you design, visualize, simulate, and publish your ideas before they are built or created.
Yes.
So this Autodesk is a leader in developing software for creators. Moreover, Autodesk continues to develop a comprehensive portfolio of state-of-the-art CAD, CAM, CE software for global markets. So this Autodesk Inventor, it is a feature-based parametric solid modeling mechanical design and automation software. I'll repeat again. Autodesk Inventor is a feature-based parametric solid modeling mechanical design and automation software, which allows you to convert your 2D sketches into 3D models by using simple but highly effective modeling tools. Okay, so Autodesk Inventor provides a wide range of tools that allows you to create real world components and assemblies. These components and assemblies can be used for generating 2D engineering drawings for production, validating designs by simulating their real world conditions, visualizations, and documentation. Okay, so Autodesk Inventor helps in reducing the development cost while maximizing efficiency and quality. Okay, so you have to start this software by installing Autodesk Inventor in your system. Okay, so I see that is installed in your system. Okay.
Yes.
And once it is installed in your system, okay, you have to just double click on Autodesk Inventor professional icon on the desktop of your system, and the system will prepare for the startup by loading all the required files of Inventor. Okay. Once all of the required files have been loaded, the startup user interface of Autodesk Inventor appears as you see here on my screen. This is the startup user interface of Autodesk Inventor. Okay. The left panel of the startup user interface of Autodesk Inventor, it provides a quick access to existing projects. Okay. Like you can start a new file Okay. Mm-hmm. Open an existing file and define a new project. It also provides quick access to Autodesk Inventor learning resources such as what's new, help, okay, tutorial, yes, gallery, community, app store, and so on. Okay. And the right panel, and the right panel of the startup user interface of Autodesk Inventor, it displays recently used files as thumbnails or a list view.
Okay.
Okay. So in Autodesk Inventor, you need to invoke different environments. Okay. There are four types of environments in Autodesk Inventor where you can make your drawings. Okay. So in Autodesk Inventor, you need to invoke different environments, and those environments are, I will just write those environments here. Let me open my whiteboard. So in Autodesk Inventor, as I mentioned, you need to invoke different environments, okay? Such as the very first environment is part environment. Mm-hmm. Second environment is assembly environment. Mm-hmm. Third environment is drawing environment. And mm-hmm. the fourth environment is presentation environment.
Okay.
Okay, respectively. So you can invoke these environments by using the respective options of the new drop-down menu. Under this new, you have all these environments.
Right, okay.
So you can invoke these environments by using the respective option of the new drop-down list, which is available in the left panel of the startup user interface.
Okay.
You can also invoke the required environment, okay, by using the new tool which is available on the quick access toolbar. On the top, you have this new tool. Can you see on the top?
Yes, left corner? Yes.
Okay. So you can also invoke the required environment by using the new tool which is available in the quick access toolbar.
Okay.
So if I click on this new tool, okay, you can see this box will appear, create new file dialog box will appear, where you will see the very first is the part. Second is the assembly. Third is the drawing. And if you scroll down, you will find presentation environments.
Okay, wonderful.
Okay,
excellent.
So the method for invoking different environments of Autodesk Inventor is what we are going to discuss next now.
Okay.
So to invoke the part modeling environment for creating a 3D solid part, okay, you can just click on the down arrow next to the new tool in the left panel of the startup user interface, and then click on part.ipt option. Okay, then you can click on part.ipt option. And when you click on that, you will see that the part modeling environment is invoked with a default template. Okay. And this is the user interface of part modeling environment. Okay. This is a user interface where I will just show you all the different options which are there here. This is the navigation bar. You can see here on the right side, navigation bar.
Yep.
Here you have view cube.
Okay.
At the bottom here, this side, you will have the status bar. You can see it is written as ready here, status bar. You can see.
Okay.
Here is the triad. You can see the triad here.
Uh-huh.
Okay. This is the browser part. This is known as browser window.
Okay.
Project browser, you can say. All the steps of your drawing will be there here in the browser.
Okay.
And then on the top, this part is the quick access toolbar.
Okay.
Entire thing is the quick access toolbar. here you have file menu on the left hand side corner. You have file menu here. Mm-hmm. Okay. And this center part is your graphic area where you're going to make your drawings.
Okay.
Is the graphic area. And this part is the ribbon. All the tools you're going to use from here.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the part modeling environment. Okay. Now just note that a template, okay, a template contains some properties of the file, such as predefined unit and drawing standard. Okay. Yes. And to change the properties of the default template, okay. Now this is the default template which is opened here.
Right? Yes.
So to change the properties of the default template, you have to click on the applications tool. Okay, you have to click on the application tools, which is in the tool tab of the ribbon. You can just go to the tools tab, go to the tools tab of the ribbon, under which you have application options tool.
Okay.
Just click on the application option tools in the tools tab of the ribbon.
Mm-hmm.
The application option dialog box will appear. And in this dialog box, you can click on the file tab. Click on the file tab.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And then you can just click on configure default template.
Okay.
Click on the configure default templates button. The configure default template dialog box will appear. In this dialog box, you can define the measurement units and a drawing standard for the default template. Okay.
Okay.
For the default template. And next, you can click after defining, you can just click on OK button. I will keep millimeters and the standard as ANSI.
Okay.
And then click on OK button. The Autodesk Inventor professional message window will appear, in which you can simply click on the overwrite button. Okay. In this button to accept the changes made in the default template.
Okay.
Okay. And then you can just close this window, application option window.
Okay.
Okay. So while explaining these steps, okay, if you want me to pause and repeat any of the step again, do let me know. Okay.
I shall do, Dinesh. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. And parallelly, you can also make a note of the steps if required.
Okay. Okay.
Now, this is the one way to invoke the part modeling environment. Okay. Mm-hmm. On the bottom, can you see part one here?
A tab, yes, I can.
Part one. Yep. We have been. Just close this. Just close this.
Okay.
It will come back to the main home user interface.
Okay.
Now, alternatively, to invoke the part modeling environment, you can click on the new tool, which is in the left panel of the startup user interface on the top.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in the quick access toolbar. So yep. when you click on that, the create new file dialog box will appear. Okay.
Okay.
You can also press, I'll just close this create new file dialog box.
Okay.
You can also press Control plus N. Press Control plus N key
Control
to invoke
plus N.
This
okay.
N. Okay. Yes, to invoke this dialog box. Create new file dialog box.
Okay.
Okay. In the create new file dialog box, you can select the default metric or English template, okay, for invoking the part modeling environment.
Okay.
Okay. Any idea about what is metric and English templates?
Obviously the metric, well, the English is imperial units, inches.
Yes.
And
yes.
Obviously, you know, the metric speaks for itself. It's, you know,
yes,
to the base 10 decimalization. Yeah.
Yes. Perfect. Very good. So you can select a default metric or English template for invoking the part modeling environment. So in the default metric template, basically the length is measured in millimeters, where areas in an English template, the length is measured in inches.
Yes.
Okay. So to invoke the part modeling environment with default metric template, you have to expand this template node in the create new file dialog box.
Okay.
And then select metric folder. Mm-hmm. Okay. All the default metric template appear on the right panel of the dialog box.
Yes. Okay. Okay.
All the default for all different environment. You will find this for all different environment. This is for part environment. This is for assembly. This is for drawing. If you scroll down, you will get for presentation as well.
Okay. Yes. Okay.
Okay. So all the default metric templates will appear on the right panel of the dialog box. Next, you can double click on standard mm.ipt template. Okay. This one, standard mm.ipt template. .ipt, here .ipt is the file extension of the Inventor part file. Okay. Inventor part file.
Inventor part file, yes. Okay.
Part file. It is the extension for Inventor part file.
Okay.
So you can simply double click on standard mm.ipt template. The part modeling environment is invoked with the default metric template. Okay. And the various user interface component of the part modeling environment, such as ribbon, browser, view cube, navigation bar, is what we will discuss next. Now.
Okay.
Okay, so these are the two ways to invoke part modeling environment. Hope this is clear to you. Hope this is clear to you how to invoke part modeling environment.
Very clear, Dinesh. Yes, thank you.
Okay, perfect. Welcome. So we will start with the ribbon. Okay, so this upper part is, this is known as ribbon, this area, this much.
That's the ribbon, yes.
Okay. And this ribbon is composed of series of tabs such as 3D model, sketch, annotate, inspect, okay, tools, okay. So this ribbon is composed of series of tabs such as 3D model, sketch, and annotate, in which a set of similar tools are grouped together in different panels.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Just note that the availability of tab, panel, and tools in the ribbon depend upon which environment is invoked.
Yes. Okay. It's invoked.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes. Here we have invoked part modeling environment. So we are finding these tabs, these tools, and ribbon for drawing, for assembly, for presentation. They will be different. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So by default, this ribbon is docked horizontally at the top of the graphic area. You can also dock the ribbon vertically to the left or right of the graphic area. Okay. And for doing so, you can right click anywhere. You can just right click anywhere on the ribbon. A shortcut menu appears. And in this shortcut menu, you can move the cursor over the docking position. The docking position.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Yes. And then select the required option in the cascading menu that appears.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. You can also undock the ribbon such that it can float within the graphic area by clicking on the undock ribbon option in the shortcut menu. Okay. In Autodesk Inventor, you can also add a custom panel, okay, with the user-defined tools in each tab of the ribbon. Okay, I will repeat again. In Autodesk Inventor, you can also add a custom panel with all user-defined tools in each tab of the ribbon. Okay. And for doing so, you can right click anywhere on the ribbon again. Mm-hmm. You can right click anywhere on the ribbon and then click on customize user command option in the shortcut menu that appears. Okay. When you click on that, the customize dialog box will appear. The customize dialog box will appear. You can see similar dialog box will appear.
Okay, yes.
Okay. Ensure that in this dialog box, you have three tabs. You have one is ribbon tab, second is keyboard tab, and third is marking menu tab.
Okay.
Ensure that the ribbon tab is selected in the customized dialog box. And next, you can select the required tab. Okay, you can select the required tab in the choose tab to add the custom panel to drop down list of the right panel in the dialog box.
Okay.
So after selecting the required tab, say I want to select this 2D drawing. Just I will click after selecting the required tab, select a tool on the left panel of the dialog box and then click on the add button. You can see this add button at the center.
Yes.
Okay. The selected tool gets added to the right panel of the dialog box.
Okay.
So similarly, you can add multiple tools to the right panel of the dialog box. And once it is added, next you can simply click on apply button. Okay. And then click close in the dialog box.
Okay.
All the selected tools, whatever you have selected there, those will get added in user command panel. You can see this command panel at the end of the selected tab. Okay. All those will get added here.
Okay, fantastic.
At the end of the selected tab. You can also change the appearance of the ribbon, to normal, desktop, small, compact, or large. And for doing so, you can simply right-click anywhere on the ribbon and then move the cursor over ribbon appearance option in the shortcut menu that appears. A cascading menu will appear. And in this cascading menu, you can select the required options to define the appearance of the ribbon. By default, the normal option is selected as the appearance of the ribbon. The reset ribbon option in the cascading menu is used for resetting the ribbon to the default settings.
Okay.
So that's all about this ribbon. And in this ribbon, there are multiple tabs. Each tab has multiple panels. Each panel has multiple tools present in it. Okay. So for example, we have this sketch tab. You can go to the sketch tab. So this sketch tab, in sketch tab, we have multiple panels like create panel, modify panel, pattern panel, constraint panel, insert panel, format panel. And each of this panel, like say create panel, has multiple tools like how you can create line, circle, arc, rectangle, fillet, text, point. So each tab is divided into multiple panels and each panel has multiple tools present in it with the help of which you can make your drawings. Next, moving ahead to the file menu. And this file menu, which is on the top left corner. So to invoke the file menu, you have to click on the file button at the upper left corner of the ribbon. And this file menu is basically used for accessing the commonly used tools, to start a new file, to open an existing file, to save a file, to export a file, to share a file, and so on. It also displays recently. It also displays a list of recently used I can say all recently used files in the recent document area.
Okay.
In the recent document area, you can see it will show you all the recently used files.
Okay, wonderful.
Okay. So this is a file tab, and then the quick access toolbar, which is at the top, this one. Okay.
Yes.
This tab at the top. So this quick access toolbar is provided with frequently used tools, okay, such as new, open, save, undo, redo, home, okay. It is also provided with material and appearance, okay. You can see material and their appearance to the model, okay. So with the help of which you can quickly assign material or an appearance to the model respectively.
Right.
And just remember, this quick access toolbar is something which is available at the upper left corner of the screen.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. In addition to the default tools, you can also customize to add or remove the tools in the quick access toolbar. Okay. And to do so, to add a tool, you have to just right click on the tool. See, if I want to add this circle tool in my quick access toolbar. Mm-hmm. So to add a tool, just right click on the tool in the ribbon, and there is an option add to quick access toolbar in the shortcut menu. Mm-hmm. Okay. The selected tool will get added in the quick access toolbar. You will see that selected tool will get added to the quick access toolbar, the circle tool, you can see. And to remove a tool from a quick access toolbar, just right click on the tool to be removed, okay, and then click the remove from quick access toolbar in the shortcut menu that appears.
Okay, perfect.
Next is the info center. This part is known as info center, this much part. In the top right corner. Mm-hmm. Okay. And this info center is available at the upper right corner of the Inventor window. And it is used for accessing the help documents. Okay. For finding information related to a topic.
Okay.
Also, it provides tools to access the Autodesk App Store. Okay. You can see there is an App Store. Sign in, sign out to Autodesk account, your account details, and also a search tool and so on, where you can just search for an help and command, whatever you want.
Okay.
That is available here. Then the window. This window is very important. Next one, as I discussed, this part on the left-hand side, this is known as browser. Okay, and this browser appears on the left side of the graphic area, and it keeps a record of all features or operations used for creating a model. Note that the first created feature, will appear at the top, at the top, and the next created feature appear one after the other in order in the browser.
Okay.
You can drag the end of the part up or down in the browser to step upward or downward through the regeneration order of the feature.
Okay.
Note that the features present after the end of part, they get suppressed and they do not appear in the graphic area. All the features present after they get suppressed and they do not appear in the graphic area.
Okay.
One thing to be noted here, here is the origin folder, this origin folder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the origin folder in the browser, it contains, if you expand this in browser, it contains three default planes. YZ, XZ, and XY plane.
Yes.
And also three default axes, X axis, Y axis, Z axis, and a center point.
Yes.
And a center point. Okay. With the help of which we are going to make our drawings.
Okay.
Okay. Next is the view cube, which is available on the upper right corner of the graphic area, which is used for navigating the model. Okay. You can orbit or switch between standard and isometric views of a model by using the view cube. Okay. You will learn to navigate a model, okay, by using view cube later in chapter number 5.
Okay. Okay.
Next is the navigation bar here.
Okay.
Okay. And this navigation bar is used for accessing navigation tools such as zoom, orbit, and pan. Okay.
Okay.
Zoom, orbit, and pan. It is available to the right of the graphic area, and the various navigation tools of this navigation bar, they are also discussed in chapter number 5. Okay, we will come that in chapter number 5.
Okay.
Just one tip here, I will tell you, you can just turn on or off the display of this view cube and navigation bar in the graphic area. Okay, in the graphic area, you can either turn it on or off. And for doing so, you can click on the view tab. You can go to the view tab in the ribbon and then invoke the user interface playout in the Windows panel. Okay. And next, you can select or clear the respective checkbox here.
Okay.
All the options, you can say view cube, navigation bar, toolbar, status bar, all those you can check, and you can check the respective check boxes here. You can clear the respective check boxes here.
Okay. Okay, excellent.
Okay. Perfect. The next last part of the user interface is the status bar. Okay. And this status bar is something which is here.
Okay.
You can see it is written as ready. As of now, it is written as ready here. Okay. So this status bar is available at the bottom of the graphic area, and it is going to provide information about the actions to be taken, okay, based on the currently active tool. Okay. It also displays the current state of the sketch being created, okay, coordinate system, and so on. So whenever you make any sketch, you're going to make any sketch, you have to keep seeing here in the status bar, because this status bar is something which will help you with all the steps. It will guide you, okay, with all the steps that you need to do. Perfect. Very good. So that's all about the part modeling environment. And this is the main environment where you're going to make your sketch or drawing, whatever you say.
Okay.
Is what we are going to make here. Okay. I'll just close this part file from the bottom. Mm-hmm. Okay. And come back to this home tab.
Yes.
So we have seen how to invoke part modeling environment. There are two ways to invoke. One is simply you can expand this new and click on .ipt, which is an Inventor part modeling extension. Mm-hmm. And other way is to click on this new option on the quick access tool.
Yes.
Next, we will see to invoke assembly environment, how to invoke assembly environment.
Okay.
Okay. Any idea what assembly environment will do?
Yeah, the assembly environment allows you to pull together various parts which you may have already created, somebody else may have created, maybe standard parts slightly, and it's to pull them all together to make the assembly which you require.
Yes, yes, exactly. Okay, so all the parts, you can assemble them in assembly environment. Okay, you can connect them, you can join them, okay? So to invoke assembly environment, for creating an assembly, you have to click on the down arrow next to the new tool in the left panel of the startup user interface, and then click on assembly.iam, .iam assembly option in the new drop-down list that appears. Okay, the assembly environment is invoked with a default template. Okay. note that the method for editing properties such as unit and drawing standard of the default template is same as we discussed earlier. So can you just repeat those steps? What was the steps with the help of which you can edit the properties such as unit and drawing standard?
Let me just open up Inventor here and move your out window there. Was it? Hold on, I haven't got a... Let me just take any part here. Has it? Okay, it's just going in. 1 second. Okay. Has it opened up a template? Come on. It's a little slow. Right, okay. So it was, was it under the tools tab?
Tools? Oh, yes.
It was tools.
Application
options. And yes. It was then file. And then it was configured default template. You went in there and you have the ability to change from metric to imperial, versa, or any drawing standard which you require.
Yes, exactly. Very good. Okay, so this is the method for editing properties such as unit and drawing standard of the default template.
Okay,
perfect. And then you can close. So alternatively, I'll just close this assembly environment also from the bottom. Assembly coming back to the home. Okay. Alternatively, to invoke assembly environment, you can just click on the new tool in the left panel of the startup user interface, that is on the quick access toolbar. The create new file dialog box will appear. You can also press Control plus N key to invoke this dialog box.
Okay.
And in this create new file dialog box, you can select the default metric or English template for invoking the assembly environment. Mm-hmm. So for that, you have to expand your template node in the create new file dialog box and select the metric folder. Okay. All the default metric template will appear on the right panel of the dialog box.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And next, you can just double click on go to assembly. And here in this, you can simply double click on standard mm.iam, the fourth option, standard mm.iam template. .iam is the file extension of Inventor assembly file. The file extension of Inventor assembly file. And when you click on that, the assembly environment is invoked with the default metric template.
Okay.
So after invoking assembly environment, you can create an assembly by assembling two or more than two part components. Okay. And you will learn about creating assemblies later in the chapter. Okay. In the later chapters.
Okay.
Perfect. So you can simply close this assembly too.
Mm-hmm.
And now I will show you how you can invoke drawing environment.
Okay.
And to invoke a drawing environment for creating a 2D drawing of a part or an assembly, you have to click on the new tool in the left panel of the startup user interface.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can simply click in the quick access toolbar, the new tool which is there on the quick access toolbar.
Yes.
Okay. So when you click that, a create new file dialog box will appear. Okay. And after invoking this create new file dialog box, you have to select the default metric or English template for your drawing environment. And then to invoke the drawing environment with a default metric template, you have to expand this template node in the create new file dialog box and then select the metric folder. All the default metric template appears in the right panel of the dialog box.
Okay.
Next, you can double click on the required drawing template in the drawing rollout of the dialog box. And this Autodesk Inventor has various drawing templates with predefined standards such as ANSI, ISO, we have GOST, BSI, DIN, GIS, for invoking drawing environment. Keep in mind here, just keep in mind here, .idw. And .idw and .dwg. There are two file extensions of a drawing file here. Okay. .idw and .dwg are the file extensions of a drawing file. Okay. So you can simply click here on DWG, click on drawing DWG. This is the one way, or you can simply go to this new and here you have drawing.dwg.
Okay.
You can click on drawing DWG option in the new drop down list that appears.
Okay.
And when you click on that, the drawing environment gets invoked with the default template.
Okay.
Note that the method for editing the properties such as unit and drawing standard of a default template is same as we discussed earlier. And the drawing environment is invoked here with the default environment. Okay. So after invoking the drawing environment, you can now generate various drawing views of a component or an assembly. You can generate different drawing views. And you will learn about generating different, generating various drawing views, also applying dimensions, also creating bill of materials, and so on in later chapters, in chapter number 13. Which will show you which will show a drawing with different drawing views of a component. I'll just close this drawing environment also. And last, we will see how to invoke the presentation environment. Invoke the presentation environment for creating an animation and an exploded view of a design, you can simply click on the new tool in the left panel of the startup user interface or in the quick access toolbar. Or you can press Control plus N key to create new file dialog box. In this create new file dialog box, you have to select a default metric or English template for invoking presentation environment. So to invoke the presentation environment with default metric template, expand the template node and then select metric folder. All the default metric template will appear on the right panel of the dialog box. You can just scroll down in the dialog box and then double click on standard mm.ipn. Just note that .ipn is the file extension of Inventor presentation file. You can just double click on that. The presentation environment is invoked and insert dialog box will appear. Insert dialog boxes appear. Also, you are prompted to select an assembly file. You can see the file type here is assembly. You are prompted to select an assembly file for creating its animation and exploded view. So you have to browse to the location where the assembly file is saved and then select it for creating its animation and exploded views. And next you have to click on this open button in the dialog box. And then the selected assembly gets opened in the presentation environment. And after invoking after invoking the presentation environment, you should be now able to create an animation and exploded view of the assembly. You will learn about the same, how to create animation and exploded view, okay, later in the chapter number, I guess chapter number 14, okay? You will see
that's
how to
good,
create animation
and Dinesh, exploded because view. Presentation, yes. This sounds quite exciting. Presentation isn't something that you normally use in CATIA, or you don't use in CATIA, sorry, or nor in X. So this, I'm quite interested in this, in learning how you can take an assembly and create a presentation and the things you can do with that assembly. So that sounds very interesting.
Yes. It's very. We will spend one full day on this presentation environment.
Okay.
On learning this, how to create animations and exploded view of an assembly.
Okay. Excellent.
Okay. Perfect. So I'll just cancel this as of now. So here the presentation environment is invoked here. I'll just close this presentation environment. Coming back to the home tab. Okay. So coming back to here. So the files created in different environments. Part, assembly, drawing, and presentation of Autodesk Inventor have different file extensions. Okay, they have different file extensions, like part file. They have file extension as .ipt. Okay, assembly, they have file extension .iam.
Yes.
Drawing, they have file extension as .idw. And there is one more, that is .dwg.
Yes.
Okay, yes. And for presentation, we have file extension as .ipn.
IPN, yes.
Yes. So these are different file extensions for different environments in Autodesk Inventor.
Okay.
Okay. Hope this part environment is used for creating the part. Assembly is used to assemble all the created parts. Okay. Mm-hmm. Presentation is basically used to create animation and exploded view of the assembly.
Yes.
And the drawing environment is where you will put all your ideas in a sheet of paper. You will create different views. You will generate different views.
Yes. Yes. Okay.
So hope all these four different types of environment is clear. What is the purpose of this environment?
Yes. Yes, it is, Dinesh. Yes.
Okay. Perfect. Very good. So coming back to this Inventor interface, and the next here we are going to see how to create and access a project.
Okay,
very important. So in Autodesk Inventor, you can create a project, okay, for organizing, accessing, and saving all the files such as parts, assemblies, drawings, standard components, library components, etc. That are associated with a particular design.
Okay.
So you can define any folder created in a local drive of your system or in a vault as the project folder for saving all the files of a particular design in a common location. Okay. Making it easier to manage all the files of the project.
Okay.
And the method for creating a project is what we are going to discuss next, okay? Where you will be saving all the files of a particular design in a common location that will make easier to manage all the files of the project.
Okay.
So for that, you have to click on the project tool in the quick access toolbar. You can see this projects. Click on the project tools in the quick access toolbar. The project dialog box appears with the display of default project in its upper half.
Okay.
In your case, the default will be selected because you're using that for first time.
Okay.
So the project dialog box appears with the display of default projects in its upper half. And a tick mark in front of project indicates that it is the currently active project.
Okay.
Okay. Note that the default project, in your case, the default project is activated in the project dialog box by default.
Right.
Okay. Okay. You can activate any of the existing project by simply double clicking on it. Okay.
Okay. Yes.
You can also invoke this project dialog box. I'll just close this project dialog box. I'll show you the other way to invoke this. You can also invoke this project dialog box by clicking on the projects and settings icon.
Okay.
The three vertical dots. Can you see this?
Yes, I can. Okay. Yes.
Okay. You can just click on projects and setting icon in the left panel. Available next to the project dropdown.
Yes.
And then click on the settings and then click on the setting option that appears.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yes,
and it will take you to, yes, it will take you to this box.
Okay.
And now you can create a new project. So if you want to create a new project, you have to simply click on the new button in the project dialog box. For creating a new project, the Inventor Project Wizard dialog box will appear.
Okay.
Okay. You have to select new single user project radio button in the Inventor Project Wizard dialog box to create a new project on the local drive of your system.
Okay.
Okay. If you want to create a new project in a vault, then select the new vault project radio button. Okay.
Okay.
So after selecting the required radio button, you can click on the next button in the dialog box. And here you can enter the name of the project to be created in the name field of the dialog box.
Okay.
I will just enter my name here. And then click on the next button in the dialog box. Click on the next button in the dialog box. Okay. Also, before clicking next button, if you want to click on the browse, you can see this browse option for the project location. You can also click on the browse button next to the project workspace folder field in the dialog box.
Okay.
And the browse for folder dialog box will appear. And in this dialog box, you can browse to the required location in the local drive of your system.
The
and then select a folder to save all the files of the project.
Okay.
All the files of your project.
Okay.
Okay. And then you can click next, click on OK button. The project folder gets defined and its location will appear in this project workspace folder of the dialog box. And then you can click on next button.
Okay.
And then you will click on finish button.
Okay.
Okay. So a project with the specified name you can see here is created at the specified location and it becomes an active project. Also, it will appear in the upper half of the project dialog box.
Right. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
So everything which we create from here on in, Dinesh, after we have created this new project folder and specified where the location is, everything we now create, parts, assemblies, presentations, drawings, standard parts, they will all be stored within that folder.
Yes, exactly.
Right. Okay.
Okay. So next, you can just click on the done button in the project dialog box.
Okay.
Now, every time you save a file or open an existing file, the active project folder location gets browsed automatically for saving or opening the file respectively.
Right. Right.
Okay. Perfect. You can also invoke the project dialog box by clicking on the project and setting icons. As I mentioned here, the three vertical dots in the left panel available next to your project drop down list in the startup user interface. And then click on the setting options that appear.
Right. Wonderful.